Hello children, welcome to today's video. In yesterday's video, we have solved the sums of exercise 2.2 up to question number 3. Now, today I am going to solve question number 4, which is regarding you have to find all the zeros of the given question. Okay, there are two ways to find the zeros, children. Number one, first way is either you can directly say that finding zeros of P of X, that means P of X equals X plus 5 equals 0. When this 5, it is plus symbol, if it goes to the other side, it will become minus 5 directly, or else it is an linear equation. We know the general form of linear equation. This is an alternate solution, children. What I am going to do now, x plus 5 is equal to ax plus b. On comparing both the sides, a value is 1, b value is 5. Henceforth, 0 of p of x is equal to minus b by a. Minus b means you should take minus 5. A is 1. No number means that is 1. Hence, your solution is minus 5 by 1 or simply minus 5. Your second question is same as first question, children. I'll give you the notes so you can check it. And if you did not understand, you can call me back. Now, your third question is P of X is equal to 2X plus 5. As I said earlier, there are two solutions. First one, write zeros of P of X and equate 2X plus 5 equal to 0. When you take plus 5 to the other side, it will become minus 5. X equal to minus 5 by 2. This is the solution. In alternate way, I can take or 2x plus 5 is equal to ax plus b. 0 of p of x is equal to minus b by a, that equal to minus 5 by 2 directly. Okay, children, both the ways are correct. If you understand any one way, you practice that same way. Don't get confused with two of the ways. Okay. So, your sixth question is P of X is equal to A of X. A not equal to 0. Don't get confused with the question, children. It is a question of only one variable where A is the coefficient of X and it is a constant which is not equal to 0. Now, let me equate zeros of P of X is equal to AX, which equal to 0. X equal to 0 by A, it is nothing but X equal to 0. Here 0 became the 0 of polynomial. So here is your solution for all the questions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If you did not understand any question, you can call me back, children. Kindly take a screenshot and complete your notes. So, now we are going to start the new topic, that is long division method. In this method, we are going to divide where the dividend is P of X and the divisor is G of X. Our main intention is to find the remainder of the given polynomial by dividing with another polynomial, children. Here we can do this by long division method first and then using remainder, how to find the remainder, I will explain you, children. So now we are going to start our division. First, what we are going to take in the quotient is very important, children. How to select the quotient? I will explain you how to select it. In the margin, you can take 3x square and divide it by x. Then what happens? X to the power of 1, x to the power of 2. So you will get the answer 3x to the power of 2 minus 1, that is 3x. Now your first quotient is 3x. Now you divide on multiplying 3x into x is 3x square. Again plus sign, because it is a binomial and it is a monomial. You have to multiply both two times. 3x, ones are 3x again. Okay. Our next step is we have to change the symbol. Here already plus is there, that became minus. Here plus is there, this become minus. Because we need to subtract, no children. These two are same with opposite symbols. Hence it got cancelled. Answer is 0. This is 3x and here is 1x. 3 minus 1 is 2, but greater number is for 3. Hence minus 2x. And bring down minus 1 here. Now again, what to select in the quotient path is important, children. Minus 2x, again you have to divide with this x and find out what to select in the quotient. XX got cancelled. You have to take minus 2 in your quotient. Minus 2. Now multiply minus 2 with this binomial. Minus 2 into x gives you minus 2x. Now minus into plus is again minus. Hence minus 2. Now again change the symbols. This becomes plus because already minus is there. These two get cancelled. Minus is there, becomes plus. 2 minus 1 is 1. Hence the remainder is 1. So now we are going to check our solution whether what we have done is correct or not. For that we know the division algorithm, that is dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, we know dividend as P of x equal to divisor is g of x, quotient is q of x, remainder is r of x. Okay, P of x is 3x square plus x minus 1. So now on substituting g of x, q of x and r of x. Now further step is we have to prove LHS equal to RHS. For that we have to do binomial multiplication here. X into 3x minus 2 plus 1 into 3x minus 2 plus 1. That is the first term, second bracket, second term, second bracket. Multiply each and every term. So this becomes 3x square minus 2x plus 3x minus 2 plus 1. Now x square term is only 1, that is 3x square. You have to either add or subtract the like terms, children. Now 3x minus 2x, answer is 1x. Next minus 2 plus 1, answer is minus 1. Henceforth LHS equal to RHS. Hence our answer is correct. Here is the notes for the long division method example 6, children. You can copy it by taking the screenshot. If you did not understand, kindly contact me. Once again, I'll explain you. Thank you, children.